With the Abyss of the Garth update came the companion rework. There are a lot of changes, like a lot. And I wanted to do a top companions video after the update, but I'm going to split it into two videos. This will be the top 5 companions part 1. So before we get into the new best companions, I'm going to quickly go over the important changes. If you want to read over all the changes, then be my guest. As always, a quick thank you for all of the members on my channel. Thank you so much for your support. It really means a lot. So, stick with me. Companions don't die anymore. They just lie down, take a nap for 60 seconds, and then get back up. This can be reduced with mods. You can still revive them like normal to speed it up. Vacuum and fetch and animal instincts still work even when they are incapacitated. There have been stat changes for all companions, more health, more shields, etc, etc. With this update brought new shield gating changes. This now affects companions, plus they get overguard as well. Most mods have been changed, I'm not going to list all of them, but regen now reduces their nap time and provides a few seconds of invulnerability after reviving. Prime's regen is obviously better here. The mod equilibrium has been changed so you can pick up health and energy orbs at max, meaning you don't need Synfiber anymore to use equilibrium. And Prime's pack leader now heals your companion for 183 health per hit, and the excess healing gives them overguard up to 2200. This is very strong. Also, accelerated deflection and the respective mods like this are very strong at the moment. On top of all of this, we have received a whole bunch of new really good companion mods, which are called bond mods, which we will go over briefly in this video, and I will do a tier list video, so stay tuned for that. Now let's get into the video. The first companion on the list is the Death Cube, and the reason why the Death Cube is now great is because of its lovely mod called Energy Generator. Energy Generator drops an energy orb after assisting in 10 kills. This means in team and group play, your energy sustain is going to be a lot better. Plus, you will naturally be running Equilibrium on your Warframe, so pair it with Synth Deconstruct and something like Energize, and you have really good energy sustain. In this video, I'm going to be showing the primed versions of companions if they have one. Feel free to use the normal variant as well. On the same note, I'll be using primed version of the mods. If you don't have them, let's say you're a beginner, then just use the normal variant. This is the setup that I'm using. Energy generator first. Just a quick note, it doesn't necessarily affect this specific mod, but generally with companion ability mods, you want to put the companion ability mod first because the game reads the mods in order of priority from left to right, the top left being first priority. So if you want your abilities to proc more often, then place them first. That's the best way that I can explain it. Primed Animal Instinct is a so-so, it's pure quality of life. We now have a permanent base plus 30 enemy radar for all frames, but this also shows loot. This is up to you, it's nice to have. This next mod is purely optional to what you want. I'm just trying out Momentous Bond, not necessarily for the 120% elemental damage, but more for the 18 second reduction of napping time. Reinforced Bond is amazing because you gain 60% fire rate when your companion exceeds 1200 max shields or overshields. Pairing this mod with weapons like the Felox, for example, with fast or multiple reloads at once, well, getting overshield is not going to be that much of an issue. Plus, I used Evolved Autoloader, the Evolution, which jumps their overshields up all the way just by holstering your weapon. Vacuum is a no-brainer, of course. Primed Regen, absolutely amazing. Lowers their recovery by 35 seconds and have 10 seconds of invulnerability. Synth Deconstruct for more health orbs, this helps with the use of Equilibrium on your frame. Accelerated Deflection is really good for faster shield regens. Calculated Redirection so we can get as close to 1200 as possible for Reinforced Bond. And Assault Mode so our companion attacks enemies. As your companion attacks enemies, it counts towards the 10 assists for Energy Generator. If your companion kills an enemy, it also counts as 1 towards the 10. When it comes to the weapons, I haven't had a chance to test all of them, but I did sink a lot of former into the Hellstrom, which looks quite promising here. This is the setup that I'm running. I went for a lot of fire rate because this thing fires really slowly. The next companion on the list is Carrier. This is a beginner-friendly companion that can be used all the way to the end game if you so desire. And that is because of this very simple but amazing mod, Ammo Case. This mod increases your ammo capacity by 25% and converts the ammo pickups into the ammo for the equipped weapon after 2 seconds. This is amazing for ammo sustain and makes those pesky weapons that struggle with ammo sustain a breeze to use. You can get Carrier from the market for 100,000 credits or you can farm the primed version. When it comes to the setup, it's a very similar build. Just know for pretty much every companion you're going to be running Vacuum or Fetch, Animal Instinct, Primed Regen and maybe Synth Deconstruct. For the most part, you will be running these mods. It is situational. Ammo case, of course, accelerated deflection, and then duplex bond. I love this mod as you get clones every time you expend 100 energy, you get a clone. If they kill an enemy, they have a 50% chance of dropping an energy orb. Naturally, companion weapons aren't the strongest, but with armor stripping and putting something like raw or nourish on your frames, it will increase their damage considerably. Calculated redirection for reinforced bond, which was such a great mod, and then assault mode so they can attack enemies. On that note, very important, if you are using your companion for stealth, I would highly suggest changing this to something else and removing their weapon so you don't break the stealth. Weapons can be Hellstrom or any weapon of your choice. Carrier will generally be used in the early game as ammo mutation mods will suffice for endgame, but it's still a good choice to use. You can also use the looter mod for carrier to open crates nearby for extra loot. Now let's move on to the next companion on the list. Oh boy, I love this one so much. I present to you free crowd control, free Magus anomaly, no need to subsume crowd control abilities, the Nautilus, the Railjack companion. This floaty friend has Cordon. This mod forces enemies within 30 meters of the target into clusters and pulls them in. The Nautilus also pulls in Eximus units even with Overguard, meaning it's a free Magus anomaly, and pair this with Manifold Bond to reduce the cooldown. Now you see where this is going. Enemies are basically just pulled in all the time, and you just need to kill them with at least 3 status effects to reduce the cooldown. The Nautilus can be paired with any frame that benefits from enemies being huddled up close together, like Baruch, Blurva, Dagath, Protea, Hydroid, etc, etc. There are many more. In terms of the build, we make use of Cordon, obviously. We run Manifold Bond to reduce the cooldowns, and then of course the usual redirection deflection so we can use Reinforced Bond. Even if you don't get the fire rate, just the simple fact that this mod is giving your companion overshields after a reload with specific weapons is quite nice. You can use any weapon with this companion. On that note of Reinforced Bond, if you do not use weapons that reload often or just don't use that kind of playstyle, you can change Reinforced Bond for something else. Remember, like I always say, my builds are guidelines, change it to your playstyle. It's your game. And that's the Nautilus. I'm going to be making use of this one a lot because it's basically just free crowd control, and having a free Magus anomaly is great for certain cases, but sadly it does not pull demolishers. I think that would be a bit broken. I highly recommend using the Railjack friend. Now onto the next friend on the list, being the Worm. The Worm has been a decent companion for a while because of the mod Negate, which is commonly used in Eidolon hunting and for other niche cases. However, because of the lack of survivability, the Worm hasn't really been used anywhere else. Of course you can, but it wasn't as great. Of course, with the new update, the Worm can survive a lot more. Sadly, very sadly, I tested this with the Manifold Bond mod, which reduces the cooldown of your companion abilities, but it does not work. However, the Worm is still going to be really nice for free status removal every 5 seconds, and it'll survive more, meaning it's better for Eidolon and general play. When it comes to the build, we obviously go Negate, that is obviously, Mystic Bond, so we get free ability costs every 25 seconds, and then of course the normal mods like shields, vacuum, regen, etc, etc, and then Reinforced Bond, which is really strong. I did go Restorative Bond here. This mod does not work with Equilibrium, sadly. It works for your companion, and it helps them to keep them alive more. This update is going to make Eidolon Hunters smile, and the Worm will be a lot better to use now. I will say I have a strong feeling a lot of these mods are going to be nerfed or at least adjusted. I know that's going to be inevitable. If anything, I hope that they just adjust the mods and not remove the mechanics entirely. But either way, the basic health and shield mods and just the fact that regen reduces their napping time by a lot is just great. And that's the Worm. I'm really excited to try and make some fun builds with it. Now let's move on to the last one on the list. A lot of people are making videos on it. I originally saw this synergy from a YouTuber called N. Please go and watch his video. I slightly adapted my take on this, but here's where I got the inspiration from. It's basically his build. He's the first person that I saw this from, so I'm going to credit him. So all credits to him. I did not find this myself. And that is the Helios. If this does get nerfed, just adapt the build accordingly, like I mentioned. The Helios is still going to be a very, very good utility companion to have. Now, what makes the Helios so great? Well, the Scanner Boy has a specific weapon that only the Helios can use, and that is the Deconstructor. Now, I may have made a brain dead moment, and as my community loves to call it, a flowment. I formed the base Deconstructor 5 times when I had the primed version. I know, just don't ask me. This is a glaive throwing weapon type, but this weapon applies impact on the first attack, puncture on the second, and slash on the third. Use mods like Shattering Impact to armor strip, pair it with Vicious Bond, which strips 15% of the enemy armor, plus enemies damaged by ability spread the effect to other enemies in a 9 meter radius. So basically AoE armor stripping. After you have done all of this, well, you get something that looks like this. Who would have thought your companion would be killing things like this? Let's get into the build. For the Helios, I use the Investigator mod. This is completely flexible. You can change it to the Detect Vulnerability mod. And then, of course, the normal Animal Instinct regen, yada, yada, yada. You know all that stuff. We use Assault here, so your companion can attack from 30 meters. It's worth noting that Targeting Receptor is a Helios-specific mod. Can also be used here. I haven't tested it enough, but this is more of an up-close and personal mod, as it's only 10 meters, but with 3 glaives. Just from the brief testing I did, it doesn't seem to do much more damage, even though it has more projectiles. But I would say I prefer using assault mode because it has a further range, because it can shoot further. Pick your poison here, you make your choice. We run duplex, as your clones will do a lot of damage. Momentous to increase their damage when killing an Eximus unit, and also drops their napping time. Vicious bond, of course, and then synth deconstruct. Let's move on to the deconstructor build. Whirlwind for glaive speed. Condition overload, because if you prime enemies, these glaives shred them. We go corrosive, so voltaic and virulent strike, just to help with the armor stripping. I do go primed pressure point, but you can swap this out for berserker fury. I'm not a super expert in the whole damage thing and how diminishing returns works in Warframe. I just have a basic understanding of it, but I will say, because of the such low base scaling and the base damage that you get from companion weapons, having the two damage mods gave me more damage versus just having something like condition overload. Shattering impact to strip them when you apply impact, and you can either go fury or reach for more range, and then quick return for the faster return when hitting an enemy, so it bounces back faster. Now we can go a few steps further. Our companion will be armor stripping, so we can add nourish onto our frames to buff the damage that they deal. This alone just melts them. Then we can add the funnies and go boat prime. You can then cast sea snares onto our enemies, making them more vulnerable to damage, and this is just something else, honestly. Oh, and let's look at the damage against demolishers. Yeah, and that's my top 5 companions part 1. I just want to mention that you can change and switch around to your liking. I just found these synergies to be really fun. With this update, there is just so many changes that there are way more combinations you can make now with different frames and companions. It's actually overwhelming. Part 2 is coming very soon. I will be making a tier list on the new mods going over them, so expect that as well. But now, that is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one.